Children, myself Suresh Ram Singh, and today I am going to teach you a poem that is The Heart of the Tree. It has been composed by Mr. Henry Kyler Burnham. Before I start the teaching, I would like to ask you a question, that is the definition of a poem. Do you understand what the poem is? Answer is being given by Mr. William Wordsworth, who says, William Wordsworth was a very great poet of English, and he says, poem is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. In other words, we can say a poem is a natural expression of strong feelings and emotions. A person is forced to express himself when some feelings and emotions are there in his heart. And in this way, the poem gets birth. The title of the poem is The Heart of the Tree. The title itself suggests the importance of planting trees. Save trees, save life. It is said. So, the importance has been given there on the planting of trees. In the poem, the poem begins with a question so that the reader can think to get the answer. And such a poem is called hyphora or antiphora. Let me repeat. A poem which begins with a question. The structure of such poem is called hyphora, H-Y-P-H-O-R-A, or antiphora, A-N-T-I-P-H-O-R-A. So, in this poem, the poet has said to us, the poet has given us the lesson, that plants are our real friends. They are the embodiment, the form of beauty. They provide happiness to each and every being, including birds, insects, animals, and human beings. They cause rain, enrich our forests, and provide food to all the creatures. One who plants a tree serves not only himself, but also his neighborhood, society, his country, and finally the whole humanity. He feels extremely happy when he plants a tree, because he knows that he is serving not only himself, not only his neighborhood, he is serving the whole of humanity. In the second stanza, the poet puts the same question and asks the readers, what does he plant who plants a tree? A person who plants a tree, what does he do in real sense? Then the poet himself suggests the answer, that he plants cool shade. Cool means soothing, which seems to be very pleasant to the body of ours. So he plants, the poet says, the person who plants cool means the tree, he plants, he manages, he arranges. Cool shade means soothing shade, and tender rain, soft rain, he just provides. And seed and bird of days to be. And he provides, he just arranges the seeds and the birds for the time to come. And ears that fade and flush again. In the third line, in the next line, he says that he works, the person who plants a tree works like a bridge between previous generation and the coming generation. Because he provides seeds and birds, and these seeds and birds will get a new life in the form of a tree. He plants the forest heritage. Heritage means culture. Culture means traditions, languages, beliefs, etc. So a person who plants a tree, plants means continues the forest culture. He just adds to the greenery of the forest. Next line is the harvest of a coming age. The joy that unborn eyes shall see. Unborn eyes means the coming generation, the generation which is yet to come. So the poet in these lines says that the person who plants a tree plants a harvest, means outcome of a crop. He says that a person who plants a tree, he just provides the outcome of a means what? Happiness, which the coming generation would see, would enjoy when they come there in the world. These things he plants, who plants a tree. And at last, the poet himself says that all these things are done by the person who plants a tree. देखिए हॉलो आएगा लिखा हुआ बीच में. In the third extract of the poem, the poet says, "What does he plant?" Means the same question he puts the reader. That means a person. What does a person do when he plants a tree? Then again, repeatedly, he suggests the answer that he plants in sap. Sap means liquid in a plant that carries food to all its parts. वो लिक्विड जो प्लांट से निकलता है और उसको प्लांट के डिफरेंट पार्ट्स को वो फूड प्रोवाइड कराता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड सैप. लीफ एंड वुड, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर प्रोवाइडेड बाय द पर्सन हु प्लांट्स अ ट्री इन लव ऑफ होम एंड लॉयल्टी. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर मीन्स ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर प्रोवाइडेड देयर इन द देयर मीन्स by the person in the home which is full of love and loyalty. Loyalty means faithfulness and far cast thought of civic good. It means the poet in the next line says that this person has the idea of common people's welfare of common people. He says that he has a very distant idea. Very four means he just foresees the idea of common welfare, his blessings on the neighborhood. When he plants a tree, he just blesses his neighboring area. Who in the hollow means who? When he plants a tree, he just holds the tree in his like this structure, and then in this hollow structure he plants. In this hollow structure, he has all the means, the development, the growth. Next line, just see the next line. Holds all the growth of all our land. He says, in the hollow structure of his hands, when he has the trees, he means he has the growth of his country. Our nation's growth from sea to sea. Means he says that. A nation's growth is in his hand. Nation's growth means from one end to the other end, the whole nation's growth is there in his hand when he plants a tree. Stirs in his heart who plants a tree. Means he feels, stirs means excites. He feels extremely happy when he plants a tree, because he knows that he is planting a tree just for the whole humankind. Means common feeling of common welfare is there in the heart of the man who plants a tree. Children, I hope that you could have understood the problem, all the problems there in the poem. If you still have any doubt, you can talk to me through phone.